Hello, good morning to all, and welcome to this module, Introduction to Architecture. Today, here I am, Kusum Chaudhary, Assistant Professor in School of Architecture in Galgotias University. So today, in this module, we are going to discuss about the building construction. In this subject, we will discuss about the door terminology topic. So let's have the next slide. In this slide, we are discussing about the objective of this module. Number one, unlearn the traditional classroom system and get acquainted to project-based learning. Second one is learning graphical representation of everyday experiences. And third is understanding professional ethics and value. So let's start to the topic with introduction to doors. As we all know about the door, we already hear about this term about the door. Basically, the door created opening in the wall is a doorway. A door is an opening in a wall that serves as connecting link between internal and external portion of the building. A door essential and primary purpose is to provide security by controlling access to the doorway. Door may have aesthetic, they can have symbolic and ritualistic purposes. As you can see in this slide, first one images is showing the ancient Roman bronze doors in the Basilica of St. John Lateran, Rome. And the second example here you can see in this door, this is showing an Islamic door decorated with geometric pattern in Morocco. And the third example, which is an example of the Art Nouveau element, this glass door is showing the decorated elements which is in Russia, St. Petersburg. And at the last, here you can see the fourth example of the door, which is an example of modern style of doors. So basically, these are the some different types of door, and you can see the various types of doors, various design of door. You can see the different types of material. As you know, our doors can be made from wood, it can be made from steel, iron, glass, and so on. Next, now function of door. In this slide, we have mentioned two functions of door. First one is primary function, which is means of access, which is mean we can access from internal to external or external to internal. Second function is secondary function, which is mean privacy functional requirements of a door. Door's basic function is maintain to privacy. So this is considered as the secondary function. And here are some other function of a door, which is like access. There should be strength in door, security should be maintained, daylight lighting should be maintained, thermal insulation, and our door should be fire resistance. Access, a adequate access relies on width and clearance. Second one is strength. The strength of external door are often subjected to harsh treatment. Sometimes, as we know, external door should be more strengthable, and it should be more width and clearance. Security. The degree of security will depend on selecting a door and frame of suitable strength. Daylight. It depends on largely on size and shape of door, position of door, and effect of internal and external reflection. Thermal insulation. Door shall be provided with thermal insulation, and for the security and safety purpose, our door should be fire resistance. Next slide is terminology of door. So first one is door unit. A door with a jamb, hinges, and door hardware. By the combination of these all factors, we get a complete door unit. Here you can see the example of jamb. This part is known as a jamb. This part is known as the hinge. And these are the some other parts of the door unit. We will discuss in detail in the upcoming slides. So next one is the double acting door. Door which is hinged so that it can be opened both side, inward and the outward. Here you can see another example of jamb. This is again jamb, and this part is known as the door stop. This is the door stop. The next slide. Now next one is the jamb, the vertical wood frame. This is the part known as the jamb. This is the vertical wood frame to which a door is hinged to create a door unit. It allows the door to be installed in the wall. So this part is known as the jamb. Next one is the stile. The stile are the vertical cross piece which hold the door panel in place. The center stile is called the mountain. So this part is the stile. This is known as the stile. Next one is the panel. These form the main body of the door, filling the space between the rails and the stile. So this part is known as the panel. Next is core, the innermost layer or center section in component construction of the door, that is known as the core. Here in this slide you can see the two types of core. This is the hollow core and this is the solid core. As by the name, these are the clear, and you can see the example of the hollow core and this is the solid core. Here you can see the top rail, and these are the hollow core, and in this this is the solid core. Again style, again lock block, door face and bottom rail. Next we comes on the bottom rail, casing, distressing and door light. Bottom rail, basically the bottom part, the bottom portion of the door is known as the bottom rail. So you can see this example of the bottom rail. Casing and trim, basically this is the wood paneling or molding that surround the interior edge of a door or window frame. Interior edge of a door or window frame, we covered this part by the molding, and basically it is used to cover the gap between the door frame and the wall. And some obviously it's used for the aesthetical reasons also. So that is known as the molding. Next is the distressing wood, a texturing technique which makes the wood to look old to worn. That is known as the distressing wood. Next is the door light, an assembly of a frame or glass panel or glass window. Many doors have more than one or one light or lights. For example, this is the light. It can be of number of 1, 2 and it can be in various number. It also depends on the design of the door and window. So this part is known as the door light. You can see the door light example in door as well as in window also. Next we comes on the parts of a door, which is like top rail, freeze rail, middle rail, bottom rail and lock style. Top rail, for example, the member at the top of the door, which is known as the top rail. Top rail is the horizontal piece that sit across the very top of the door, which is very clear by the name of the top rail. So this is the top rail. Freeze rail, similar to the top rail, except It sits horizontally across the next divide down between the panels on the door. This often at eye height, and not on all doors have a cross rail. This is sometimes known as the cross rail. Known also as the cross rail. This is the freeze rail. And we can also call this is the cross rail. Middle rail, as it is also clear by its name, middle rail. This is lie in the middle of the door. Not all door have a middle rail. Obviously, it depends on the again design of the door. And this is the door handle. And sometime we can call it the lock rail also. Bottom rail sits horizontally across the very bottom of the door. Here you can see the clear example of the bottom rail. Next we comes on the lock style. This is the vertical edge of the door which sits on the opposite side of the door of the hinges and contain the lock of latch. Here you can see the lock style, and in this style we put the lock rail. As it is clear in the this image, this is the lock style. This is the lock style, and this is the vertical edge of the door, which basically which provide on the opposite side of the door to the hinges, and it contain the lock or the latch. This part contain the lock or the latch. Next we comes on the top mullion, mid mullion, lower mullion, molding, frame or lining. Top mullion, again it is very clear by its name. This part is known as the top mullion. Mullion basically the vertical member, a vertical part of door is known as the mullion. Mid mullion, this is the vertical element that form a division between panel in the area. Directly below the top mullion, this is sometimes known as the second mullion. So this is the top mullion and this is the mid mullion. And as I mentioned, the vertical member of a door known as the mullion. So these are the top and mid mullion. Next is the lower mullion. As is mentioned by its name, lower mullion, which is located at the lower part of the door. So this is the lower mullion. Next is the molding. This is decorative detailing that can be used around the edge of the door style, rail and mullion. It may be simple or highly decorated. I also mentioned in the previous slide by the means of the molding. Basically, this molding used for the decorative purpose. It can be used in the exterior of the door or as well as in the interior of the door. Next is the frame or lining. The door frame, external or lining, internal, that is what the door fits within and which cover the wall. So these are the some terminologies of the door. And next, now part of a door frame in details. First one is head. Basically, the head is the part of the door frame that sits horizontally to form the top of the frame. This is the part is known as the head. Next is the leg or jamb. These are the term commonly used to refer the vertical component that form the side of the door frame. So this part is known as the leg, and we can call it the jamb also. Next is the architrave, which is basically which is used for the decorative purpose. This is referred to the decorative molding on the outermost edge of the door frame or lining. So this part is known as the architrave. This is using for the decorative and aesthetically purpose at the edge of the door frame. Next one is the sill or threshold. This is the bottom portion of the exterior door frame. This is the bottom portion and is used internally when transitioning from one floor covering to another floor. So this part is known as the sill or thresholding. Next is the stop. Basically, the stop is used to rest the door against when it closed. Here in this image, you can see the example of stop. This is the stop at the vertical part, and this is the creating as the stop at the top of the head. Basically, in the case of door lining, these are the thin strip of wood that are mounted along the length of jamb and the head to serve the same purpose. So these are using as the stop. Next, we comes on the. I would like to conclude this lecture. Doors are usually an important character defining feature of a historic structure. They provide scale to a building and help to define the importance of the significance facade, as I mentioned in the first slide, as well as being central to the composition of the individual building facade. And some doors are associated with specific architecture style, although glass panel door with stained glass, for example, are used in a variety of period design, for example, of Gothic period glass doors, glass design, doors designs. And many historic doors are notable for their craftsmanship, material placements and finishes. Since an appropriate door can severely affect the character of a historic house, one should be careful to avoid radical alteration to an old door and to choose a new door that is appropriate to the design of the house. In this slide, here are given some references regarding this lecture. So you can use for more detail these following references. And in this slide, here are given some questions for assignment. Question number one, definition of doors and explain different type of door which is used in history. Example, explain your questions with appropriate sketches. For example, Islamic door, Gothic door styles, or Art Nouveau door styles, and so on. And question number two, what are the different terminology of a door? Explain with suitable sketches. And question number third is, you have to define these following terminology like door light, casing molding, top mullion, freeze rail, lock style, jamb and panels. So these are the three questions for your assignment. So you have to answer these questions. And at the end, I would like to thank you.